Let's sum up the Red Sox in the last couple of days. They lost a series to Baltimore. They had an off day. They just lost Garrett Whitlock for 15 days to the same injury Jeffrey Springs had, which required Tommy John surgery. And they lost last night to the Cleveland Guardians. I forget the score, and I don't feel like looking it up right now. But the Red Sox are 13-14 right now through 27 games. And we're going to be honest with you. It's not looking great, but the Red Sox have had some bright spots, and one of those bright spots is what we're going to talk about today, Jarren Duran. So far, in 11 games being up, Duran has completely revitalized his career. Well, he struggled for the first two seasons, but now Duran looks like a completely different baseball player. He's hitting the ball hard, and it's good signs for the Red Sox. Now, without going into all this in the intro, again, as always, this was the intro, but we're going to go into his 2021 and 2022 seasons, compare them to his 2023 seasons, and then go into what Duran being hot means for the Red Sox with all these injuries and what it could mean to potentially propel the Red Sox into maybe a little winning streak here in the future. The first 2 years of Jarren Duran's baseball career were MLB career, but they were kind of forgettable. In 2021, Duran played in 33 games, he hit for a .215 average, reached base at a .241 clip, an OPS of .578, two home runs, 10 RBIs, four walks, 40 strikeouts, only two stolen bases. Four walks to 40 strikeouts is an abysmal clip. Duran did have his first hit at Yankee Stadium against Garrett Cole, but other than that, that's a pretty bad year and a pretty horrible strikeout to walk ratio. In 2022, wasn't much better for Duran. 58 games, .221 average, .283 on base percentage, .645 OPS, three home runs, 17 RBIs, 14 walks, 63 strikeouts, and seven stolen bases. So he walked a little more, but again, he played in 25 more games, so that's expected. 100 more plate appearances, at least. I think that's 112 more plate appearances. But again, not really stuff you want to see from Duran. So really struggling. Not great stuff. Red Sox fans didn't know what they were going to get. They knew Duran had potential. Really wasn't putting it together at the big league level yet thus far. But as you'll see and as we'll talk about right now, 2023 has been a completely different story for the Red Sox outfielder. The question will be, is 2023 the year of Jarren Duran? So far, it has been. In 11 games played in the 2023 season, Duran is hitting a .436 average, reaching base at a .455 clip, an OPS of 1,172, one home run, 10 RBIs, three walks, 12 strikeouts, and two stolen bases. Now, those numbers are very good, but if you've been watching the games, it's the little stuff. Duran has 8 doubles in 11 games for the Red Sox so far in 2023, and every time he hits the ball, it's hitting hard. Duran constantly is hitting the ball over 100 miles per hour, and he's really sitting at a 107, 108 exit velocity for the season when he makes contact with the ball solidly. Even his outs are hit hard, which is kind of crazy. But with Adam Duvall going down, Duran coming up and stepping up is so huge for the Red Sox. And if Duran could stay hot, the roster construction could get really, really, really interesting come June and July when Duvall is back. So if Duran stays hot, what do you do with Duvall? What do you do with Duran? Because you can't really sit either of them with what you've seen so far. It's tricky, but what the Red Sox are getting from Jarren Duran right now is so huge. Obviously, Duran stepping up for the Red Sox means a lot. Without Duran out there, the Red Sox have a clear hole, and even if Duran was hitting like his 21-22 self, I mean, the Red Sox have a clear hole out there, and it's kind of an automatic out every time he steps up, because a .215, .221 average, and a guy that really doesn't get on base is not going to cut it out there to replace a guy who was as hot as Adam Duvall. But obviously, Duran stepping up creates some stability in the Red Sox lineup, and for many, last night against Cleveland, you know, people were trusting the bottom of the lineup more in Duran and Kike more than Devers and Yoshida and Turner. So Duran stepping up for the Red Sox gives pitchers a reason to have to fear the Red Sox bottom of the order, whereas guys like Connor Wong, who's kind of been hitting well lately, and even Christian Arroyo, and you know, we just lost Yu Chang for a little while, but Duran stepping up creates stability in the lineup that really no one else was going to be able to fill. So If the Red Sox can keep getting this production from Duran and the pitching can improve, could be some good stuff here in the future for the Red Sox. And that's it. Obviously, Jarren Duran stepping up for the Red Sox is massive, and all Red Sox fans are now kind of hoping that this is the breakout year for a guy who's here to stay now for good. If you like this video, feel free to hit that like button, share the video, comment on what other videos you'd like to see us make, and most importantly, hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on awesome videos like these. Also, there will be a few links in the description of the video that will take you to our TikTok for highlights, recaps, and much more, our Twitter for live tweeting at All News Red Sox, and it's not even new anymore, it's been out for a while, our podcast, Inside the Sox. It's a great listen. I've been on, I think I've been on an episode. Hint, I may be on another episode soon. May ask the guys if I can head on. But it's always a good time there, so go give that a watch. Go give that a follow, whatever you do. And for all of us here at Grandstand Productions, we hope that you enjoyed this video. And hopefully we'll see you again next time. Go Sox!
I'm gonna tell you a story.